Greetings. Praise the Lord for hearts asking honest questions. My question is that in Isaiah, God talks about sending a prophet. In Isaiah, is that prophet Jesus? If it is, then how does Isaiah 42:13 apply to him? Greetings, my friend. It is important to respect God by reading all the context that surrounds a passage. Isaiah 42:1 begins with these verses. Isaiah 42:1, "Here is my servant, whom I uphold, my chosen one in whom I delight. I will put my spirit on him, and he will bring justice to the nations." This refers to Jesus and is confirmed in Matthew 3:16. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment heaven was opened, and he, John, saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. And further confirmed in Matthew 12:17. This was to fulfill what was spoken through the prophet Isaiah. "Here is my servant, whom I have chosen, the one I love, in whom I delight. I will put my spirit on him, and he will proclaim justice to the nations." And again in Luke 3:22, "And the Holy Spirit descended on him in bodily form like a dove, and a voice came from heaven, 'You are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased.'" Jesus also claimed the Spirit of God was on him in Luke 4:18. "The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free." Isaiah 42 continues in verse 2, "He will not shout or cry out or raise his voice in the streets." Again, the New Testament claims this is fulfilled by Jesus in Matthew 12:18 and 19. "Behold my servant, whom I have chosen, my beloved, in whom my soul has found delight. I will put my spirit upon him, and he will proclaim justice to the Gentiles. He will not quarrel, nor will he cry out, nor will anyone hear his voice in the streets." Isaiah 42:3, "A bruised reed he will not break, and a smoldering wick he will not snuff out. In faithfulness he will bring forth justice." Isaiah 42:3 is likewise cited in Matthew 12:20. So there is no question that Isaiah 42 begins by speaking of this servant of God who happens to be Jesus. Then in verse 5, prophet Isaiah's specific message changes tone and content from describing the servant of God to God the Father himself speaking. "This is what God, the Lord, says, the creator of the heavens, who stretches them out, who spreads out the earth with all that springs from it, who gives breath to its people and life to those who walk on it. I, the Lord, have called you in righteousness. I will take hold of your hand. I will keep you and will make you to be a covenant for the people and a light for the Gentiles." Who is this that God is talking about? Called you in righteousness, will take hold of your hand, will keep you, will make you to be a covenant. Notice who this is for. For the people, meaning Israel, and for the Gentiles. I believe this is also talking about Jesus and the covenant he forms, establishes with his own blood. It could not be Israel or the people, because this one will be made a covenant for the people and the Gentiles. God talks about sending a prophet in Isaiah. Is that prophet Jesus? There is a key scripture in Malachi which I need to reference here. God used prophet Malachi to reveal that God would come to his temple as a prophet, that God would come as a messenger of the covenant the Jews desired. That means it could not be the covenant they already had, meaning it was a new covenant. Malachi 3:1, "I will send my messenger." This is God talking. "I will send my messenger, who will prepare the way before me. Not before another prophet, before me. Then suddenly, the Lord you are seeking will come to his temple, God's temple. The messenger of the covenant whom you desire will come, says the Lord Almighty. God came to his temple as a prophet to bring the new covenant. Then we come to a really cool verse. Isaiah 42:8, I am the Lord, Yahweh. That is my name. I will not yield my glory to another or my praise to idols. God actually says in the Hebrew, I am Yahweh or Yahweh. That is my name. And this should forever settle any debate or claim. What is the name of God? The word God is a positional title like king or president. Yahweh or Yahweh is God's actual name. Then Isaiah 42 again changes tone at verse 10 with a third-person description of praise for God, beginning with, Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise from the ends of the earth, you who go down to the sea and all that is in it, you islands, and all who live in them. Finally, we reach 42:13, which continues in the context of describing God. The Lord, Yahweh, will march out like a champion. Like a warrior, he will stir up his zeal. With a shout, he will raise the battle cry and will triumph over his enemies. All these pronouns refer to Yahweh. Respecting the text, we know this is Yahweh and therefore Almighty God. But including knowledge from the other prophets, we know that Jesus fulfills many descriptions of Yahweh. Then the question becomes, when might Jesus march out like a champion and a warrior? This comes at the end of days, during something called the Second Coming of Christ. Revelation 19:11, I saw heaven standing open, and there before me was a white horse, whose rider is called Faithful and True. With justice he judges and wages war. I've actually had a Muslim tell me this is Muhammad. Islam's claims always rely on ripping a verse out of context. As we will see, there is no way this can be Muhammad. The next verse, Revelation 19:12, His eyes are like blazing fire, and on his head are many crowns. He has a name written on him that no one knows but he himself. He is dressed in a robe dipped in blood, and his name is the Word of God. We know that Jesus is the Word of God made flesh. John 1:14, And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. We know this cannot be Muhammad. The armies of heaven were following him, riding on white horses and dressed in fine linen, white and clean. Coming out of his mouth is a sharp sword with which to strike down the nations. He will rule them with an iron scepter. He treads the winepress of the fury of the wrath of God Almighty. On his robe and on his thigh he has this name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We know this cannot be Muhammad. This is my understanding of how Jesus fulfills Isaiah 42:13, brother. Jesus is one with Yahweh, and Jesus fulfills the descriptions that the prophets gave about Yahweh. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.